Before we move on to government regulation of monopolies and antitrust, here's a more formal analysis of why the government cares about monopolies in the first place. If we assume that the purpose of the government is, generally speaking, to look after the well-being of society, then let's look at a breakdown of the benefits to society from a competitive market structure versus a monopolistic market structure. Remember that any given market will have consumers and producers, so what does each side gain by being involved in that market? If you remember from the market prologue episode, buyers enter a market to acquire a product. Each buyer has a maximum price that he or she is willing to pay. This is the individual consumer's subjective price, but would like to pay less. If the market price, the objective price, is less than what the consumer is willing to pay, then he or she has consumer surplus, where consumer surplus is defined as the subjective price minus the objective price, i.e., the consumer surplus is the difference between what the consumer would have been willing to pay and the market price that he or she did pay. If you look at the market as a whole, the total consumer surplus is the sum total of the surpluses realized by each of the consumers. Is there any benefit to the producers? Sure. Remember from the market prologue video that the sellers enter the market with a subjective price too, the minimum price that he or she would be willing to accept. As long as the market price, the objective price, is higher than the seller's subjective price, then the seller realizes a producer surplus. By definition, producer surplus is the objective price minus the seller's subjective price. For the market as a whole, the total producer surplus is the sum total of the surpluses of each of the producers. The benefit to society as a whole, then, is the consumer surplus added to the producer surplus. So, what do the consumer surplus and the producer surplus have to do with monopoly? Let's take a look at a monopolistic market. Remember, the consumer surplus is the area above the market price, up to the demand curve, which shows what the consumers would have been willing to pay. The producer surplus is the area above the supply curve, the minimum amount the producer would have accepted, up to the price line. Remember, the total benefit to society, then, is the consumer surplus and the producer surplus. Now, compare the benefit to society under a competitive market to a society under a monopoly. The difference, this triangle, is the deadweight loss to society. The existence of this deadweight loss is the reason that the government, if interested in society's overall well-being, interferes with monopolies. Coming up, government regulation of monopolies.